Watauga Arts Council with your host, Cherry Johnson, serving arts in Watauga County for more than 30 years.
Hi, I'm Cherry Johnson with Watauga County Arts Council. As you know, the Arts Council has a gallery that we manage in the Jones House Community Center called the Maisie Jones Gallery. And it's an invitational gallery, which basically means that artists can apply to be exhibited in this gallery, and we invite them to come and share their work with us. We have a couple of artists here today with us that I think you're really, really going to enjoy getting to know. You probably will remember Teresa Cerda. Teresa is, you've done two or three shows with us in the past.
Yes, I think it's my fourth.
Fourth.
Wow. Show in Jones House. Wow. Yeah.
And she has brought along a wonderful friend, and I'm going to attempt this. I'm going to do it. Julia Rechenbach, Moomaw.
Wonderful.
Close? Great.
Okay. Yeah. And so I've so much enjoyed getting to know Julia very much. She is a wonderfully creative person, and the story of how these two got together and began doing their art is worth sharing with you. So the first thing I'm going to say is, how did you two meet?
I teach German at ASU and have been doing so for almost 20 years. And Teresa's husband is teaching in my department, and that's how we first met.
Yeah, 7 years ago.
7 years ago, and I was the first person you met, you say?
I think so, yes. I was the first person. I remember your face.
And that's about the time that I had touched clay for the first time and put together my love for art and my love for sculpture and making sculpture. And Teresa and I shared being artists and talking about art.
Exactly. We get together, I think, for 2 years or three mm-hmm. years. And we get together every week to work together and share our experience, our wish about the art, the life.
But what you do is so different. You know, I mean, you're in clay, primarily. Well, you do a lot of things, but mostly clay. And you are...
Cooking.
cooking paint, put it in on wood.
Yeah. Yeah. Cooking on the wood. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, but we shared a lot of way. We are interested in the same artists, and we are interested in everything.
Teresa, when you came here, you were already an artist. You have been an artist for many years. What's your background?
My background is, what do you mean?
What did you do before you came to Boone, art-wise?
I am artist. I start to art because I was studying stage design. Mm-hmm. I work in theater. Then one day I was in my studio making my stuff, and one person comes, "Oh, beautiful work. Are you artist?" "No, I'm state designs." "Ah, I like everything. I will buy everything." "Ah, okay, I will be artist." Yeah, it's true.
But where did this happen? True. Where was this?
Who? He was a gallerist.
No, where was
where?
This?
Excuse me, in Spain, Madrid. I live in Spain for 20 years. I'm from Chile.
Uh-huh.
And this
happened, and you really didn't intend to be an artist. You were stage designer.
I was very glad with my stage design,
but you know,
everything is in connection.
A stage
designer
is an artist.
It's an artist, of
yes,
course.
Yeah.
It's an artist, uh-huh. of course. Yeah. But it was curious because that day I was working in several proof for the background,
uh-huh.
and the people love him. He bought everything. I said, interesting. I was very young.
Yeah.
I was in my 20s. You know,
that is cool. And so you started painting and selling your paintings, and
yeah.
you've been doing that ever since, I guess.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And now, before I go to Julia, because she's got a huge story I want to share with everybody too, but. You, we talked about cooking paint, and for those people who have not seen a previous interview with you, quickly explain what you cook.
I cook. Well, right now I'm working with encaustic. Encaustic. You cannot buy
right.
the encaustic. You have to cook with the
no rabbit glue in this?
Yes, of course, all the time. I am very interested in the materials. This is my focus. The material. If you see my work, all the pieces are very similar,
right.
But change the material. I am all the time doing some investigation about the material. I mix.
You're almost a chemist.
Yeah. I am very interested with the pigment, with the mediums, with the. What happened? Well, many.
So if I recall, it's egg tempera and rabbit glue.
And caustic, yes,
and caustic. Okay, and then all of this goes on to big wood panels.
Exactly. Uh-huh. I paint on wood because the wood holds all the material.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's heavy.
This tiny little girl lifts these great big wooden pieces
up.
Okay, now, Julia, you were a language teacher. Where did the art come in? How did this happen?
I grew up in Germany and lived in Germany for 20 years and always loved art and mm-hmm. have art in my family. My uncle was an artist. And growing up, I was more of a musician and my brother mm-hmm. was the artist. So really, I never lived my art, but I always loved sculpture and I took photographs of sculpture.
Uh-huh.
I would travel to Italy and to France and to Greece with my school, and I always was fascinated by sculpture and took pictures of it. So I always had the dream of one day being Michelangelo, or at least having Michelangelo around me. So, but then my young son, I have two sons, and my son was 7 and got better and better at working with clay, and so I had to take a class with him so he could take an adult class, and I touched clay and I just fell in love with the material.
Ah.
And it was, for me, the perfect material to build sculpture with.
Yeah.
I could make faces, I could work on expressions, and the piece would just somehow magically appear under my hands, using a lot of patience mm-hmm. in going slow enough. But I just love what clay does. And just Teresa talking reminds me of another parallel that we have, that we both love natural materials.
Mm-hmm.
We work with natural materials.
Exactly.
Teresa,
organic
materials. And Teresa works with color pigments. And I actually use the pigments she uses in some of my underglazes.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. We share materials.
Yeah, and she brought me all my pigments
yeah.
from Germany.
Yeah.
Because they're cheaper than United States.
Well, I remember when you got a grant, you bought paint in
yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Spain. Because
exactly.
It was cheaper.
Yeah, and yes. the pigment right now are all of them from Germany.
Yes.
She
How
brought
about
me.
That?
Yeah, because they're
How
cheaper.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, but 10 times cheaper than here.
That's
so
amazing.
It's amazing.
Now, this show has a unique name and a history behind the title. So tell us about this.
So we were thinking of having the show together and then started thinking, okay, what really is connecting us here? Mm-hmm. What is connecting us is that we both came from other continents, because Teresa really is from Chile originally. And we made our home here because of our husbands being here.
Mm-hmm.
And we could do that by connecting to the earth here.
Mm-hmm.
And we are both very influenced by our connection with nature. We both love our gardens and working in the gardens. Mm-hmm. And I think that for an immigrant, that kind of connection to the earth is very, very important. And it is part of our art. That's what is reflected in our art.
So the name of the show is?
Terra Nueva, the new earth, the new land.
New earth, yeah, new
yeah.
lands.
It has
land
all kinds of
earth.
Significance,
yes.
yeah,
mm-hmm.
multiple layers.
It has multiple
uh-huh.
layers.
Yeah, but
and
Terra
I love
Nueva
that.
Is Italy.
Italian. So that's
yeah,
where we.
Exactly.
That's where we.
The common language.
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So this exhibit is going to be on display for throughout the month of May in the Macy Jones Gallery, and I hope you make a point of coming by to see it. It's wonderful art. It's very fresh and creative feeling. I barely got a chance to see it yesterday. They just barely got it on the walls, and I ran through the gallery for a reason and went, oh, this is great. But I didn't get a chance to really examine it closely. I'm looking forward to that very much. And there's going to be a reception coming up on Friday night, May the, I guess it's the 4th.
Uh-huh.
And
fourth.
It will begin at 6:30 and go until 8. It'll give you a chance to come and get acquainted with these two because they're fascinating people, and I really enjoy, I've known Teresa for quite a while, and I just have recently met Julia, and I love both of them. I think they're wonderful to talk to. I think you're going to have a great time learning more about them and about their artwork. And I hope that you will be able to come and enjoy it. I also want to make a shout out. Our dear friends at Cheap Joe's Art Stuff not only support our galleries, but they have been our gallery supporter for, oh my gosh, 6-7 years mm-hmm. that they have continued to support our galleries. And we just want to thank them for all the support they've given us for all these years and will continue to give us and the friendship we share with them. And you're just going to have to find a way to buy some of your stuff at Cheap Joe's. But do come out, meet these folks, enjoy the galleries, and enjoy the arts. We've got so much going on in this community, so many wonderful things to see. Do you have websites?
Yes, we do. We do, and maybe we can just...
We'll put the website names up. Mm-hmm. And so check their websites. Also, you can always check the Arts Council's website, watauga-arts.org, for this and so much more.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Watauga Arts Council with your host, Cherry Johnson, serving arts in Watauga County for more than 30 years.